after learning addition and subtraction of like and unlike fractions, now we must learn how to compare fractions. You have learned how to compare numbers. So in this video, we are going to learn how to compare fractions. Why? Because comparison of fractions is very important. Whether you have got more number of pieces out of a cake or not, you should know, na? Chalo, then today we are going to learn it and let's go to the PowerPoint presentation.
Comparison of fractions. In this, children, we are going to study like fractions first of all. We are going to compare like fractions. Now you remember, like fractions are those fractions which have same denominator. For example, these two fractions. Now these two are some parts of a pizza. This is 6 upon 8 of the pizza and this is 7 upon 8 of the pizza. Now, which one of you feel is more, 6 upon 8 or 7 upon 8? So, here you can see there are 7 pieces and here only 6 pieces. So, children, obviously 7 upon 8 is more than 6 upon 8. Same way, here there are two cakes. These cakes have been cut into 8 equal pieces and both the cakes are identical. One child gets 5 upon 8 of the cake. This shaded portion is 5 upon 8 of the cake. The other child gets 3 upon 8 of the cake. This shaded portion is 3 upon 8. Now you can easily make out that 5 upon 8 is more than 3 upon 8. So children, when the fractions are like fractions and we are comparing them, then that fraction, the value is more which has a bigger numerator. So for like fractions, when you have to compare like fractions, you have to compare their numerators. The bigger numerator means the value of the fraction is more. Okay, let us compare these fractions given to us. 12 upon 37 and 23 upon 37. So, if you get 12 out of 37 grapes, that will be more, or 23 out of 37 grapes would be more? Obviously, 23 upon 37 would be more. So, let us compare all these fractions. 44 out of 91 or 29 out of 91. Obviously, 44 out of 91 is the bigger fraction. 7 out of 19 or 11 out of 19. Which one is bigger? 11 out of 19, because 11 is bigger than 7. Okay. 23 upon 46 or 11 upon 46. Now, since 23 is more than 11, so 23 is bigger than, 23 upon 46 is bigger than 11 upon 46. Same way, these are also like fractions. 5 upon 23, 1 upon 23. Since 5 is more than 1. So, 5 upon 23 is bigger than 1 upon 23. 17 upon 58. 29 upon 58. Since 29 is bigger than 17, so 29 upon 58 is bigger than 17 upon 58. 87 upon 101, 43 upon 101. Since 87 is bigger than 43, so 87 upon 101 is bigger than 43 upon 101. Lastly, 3 upon 67, 13 upon 67. Children, since 13 is bigger than 3, so 13 upon 67 is bigger than 3 upon 67. Children, I am sure you would agree with me that comparing like fractions is very, very easy. You just have to see the numerator. The fraction whose numerator is bigger, that fraction is greater. Okay. Now, we are going to compare fractions with same numerators. Okay. Now, see these two figures. They are identical circles. This circle has been divided in three equal parts, and this circle has been divided in four equal parts. Here, one out of three parts has been shaded, and here one out of four parts has been shaded. Now, children, when you divide a figure in three parts, each part is bigger than the time when you will divide the same figure in four equal parts. As the number of parts increase, their size decreases. See, children, in this is one third. This is one third. And here you can see this is one fourth. So one third is bigger than one fourth. Okay, look at these two triangles. They are identical triangles. Now, this triangle has been divided in two equal parts. So, 1 upon 2. This green part is 1 upon 2. This triangle has been divided equally among three parts. It has been divided into three parts. And this yellow part is 1 upon 3 or 1 third. Just by looking at these, you can make out that 1 upon 2 is bigger than 1 upon 3. Okay. Now, again, these are two exactly identical circles. This circle has been divided into 8 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 equal parts. And this circle has been divided into 6 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, 3 out of 8. This green portion is 3 out of 8. 3 upon 6. This yellow portion is 3 upon 6. Which one is bigger, children? 3 upon 8 or 3 upon 6? Please compare them. Just by looking at them, you can make out. Yes, 3 upon 6 is bigger than 3 upon 8. So, children, in all these examples, you have to see, since their numerators are same, numerators are equal, the fraction which has smaller denominator, the value of that fraction will be more. See, here 3 upon 6 is more than 3 upon 8. Here 1 upon 2 is more than 1 upon 3. See, 2 is smaller than 3, but 1 upon 2 is greater than 1 upon 3. So, when the numerators are same, the fraction which has smaller denominator, the value of that fraction is more. See, children, there is a slightly ulta thing here. So you have to pay attention. And why it is so, you have understood. if the denominator is small, it means we have divided the figure into less number of equal parts. If denominator is big, it means the number of equal parts are more. And if the size is same and you will divide a thing into more parts, naturally every part will become smaller. Okay, come here and look at this. In this figure, the circle has been divided in 8 equal parts. Let us see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 equal parts. And here in this figure, the circle has been divided it into 16 equal parts. Okay, let us start counting from the green portion. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. It has been divided into 16 equal parts. Now 5 upon 8 is the green part. 5 parts out of 8 parts. And 5 upon 16 are these green parts. They are 5 parts out of 16. So children, these two figures clearly show you, if you divide a figure into more number of divisions, then the individual part, every part will become smaller. Here one part is smaller than this one part. So why? Because here the circle has been divided only in 8 parts. And here the circle has been divided into 16 parts. So 5 upon 8 is bigger than 5 upon 16. Okay, let us see this. 2 upon 4. The green part is 2 upon 4. Here the yellow part is 2 upon 3. So children, here the circle has been divided into only 3 parts. And here the circle has been divided into 4 parts. Now 2 out of 4 is this and 2 out of 3 is this. So you can, this is half, but this is more than half. So you can see that 2 upon 3 is bigger than 2 upon 4. Okay, now look at this pentagon. This pentagon has been divided into 5 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 2 out of 5 parts have been shaded. Now this pentagon has been divided into 10 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And out of 10 parts, they have shaded 2 parts. So this blue part is 2 upon 10. And here the blue part is 2 upon 5. So naturally, children, very clearly you can see that 2 upon 5 is bigger than 2 upon 10. Okay. Oh, here though you can easily make out. These circles are identical. They are equal in size. This circle has been divided into 6 parts. And this circle has been divided into 16 parts. The yellow portion is 2 upon 6. And here green portion is 2 upon 16. Since the number of parts have increased, the individual part has become small. Each part has become small. So this is 2 upon 16. And here this is 2 upon 6. So you can easily see that 2 upon 6 is bigger than 2 upon 16. Okay, here 4 upon 6. This yellow part is 4 upon 6. And here we have 4 upon 16. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 out of 16. So which one is bigger, children? The yellow part or the green part? Yes, the yellow part is bigger. So 4 upon 6 is bigger than 4 upon 16. Now children, before I move to more pair of fractions where we have to compare, Remember, when both the numerators are same, then we have to see the fraction which has the smaller denominator, that fraction has got more value than the other fraction. Okay. Let us compare these fractions with same numerators. 12 upon 37 and 12 upon 19. Here in this fraction, the denominator is small, so 12 upon 19 is bigger. 44 upon 89 and 44 upon 91. In these two fractions, here the denominator is small, it is 89. So the thing has been divided only in 89 parts. But here the thing has been divided in 91 parts. So 44 upon 89 is bigger than 44 upon 91. Okay, 11 upon 19 and 11 upon 7. Now children, here 7 is smaller than 19. So 11 upon 7, the value is going to be more than the value of 11 upon 19. Okay. 23 upon 46 and 23 upon 61. Since the numerators are same, so the fraction which has the smaller denominator, that fraction will be bigger. So 23 upon 46 is bigger than 23 upon 61. 5 upon 23 and 5 upon 99. Now 23 is smaller, so 5 upon 23 is bigger than 5 upon 99. 17 upon 69 and 17 upon 58. Now children, again the numerators are same. So the fraction which has got the smaller denominator will be bigger than the other fraction. So 17 upon 58 is bigger than 17 upon 69. Okay, 87 upon 11 and 87 upon 101. Now the fraction which has smaller denominator, the value of that fraction will be more. So this is 87 upon 11 is bigger than 87 upon 101. Okay, children, last question. Again, we have same numerators. So we have to compare denominators. Now the denominator which is small, that fraction is going to be bigger. So 13 upon 6 is bigger than 13 upon 67. So now we are going to study comparison of unlike fractions. So children, I want to tell you, it is going to be very easy for you. You know why? Because already you have done addition and subtraction of unlike fractions. This is exactly like that. Only in the last step, you need to compare. Now, these are unlike fractions. First of all, we will change them into equivalent fractions, which are like, which have the same denominator. How can we do that? Come on, recollect. What did you do in addition and subtraction? Think. We will multiply the numerator and denominator here by 3. And we will multiply the numerator and denominator here by 2. Let us see. See children, 1 upon 2 into 3 over 2 into 3. Here also 1 upon 3 into 2 into 2. So, we will find out the answer. Here it is, 3 ones are 3 and 3 twos are 6. Here it is, 2 ones are 2 and 3 twos are 6. So 3 upon 6 is bigger or 2 upon 6 is bigger? Naturally, 3 upon 6 is bigger. Okay. Now again, these fractions are unlike. Here the denominator is 5 and here the denominator is 4. So this one we will multiply numerator and denominator by 4. And this one we will multiply numerator and denominator by 5. Let us see. 1 into 4 upon 5 into 4. 3 into 5 upon 4 into 5. Why 5? Because here the denominator is 5. So 4 ones are 4, 5 fours are 20. 3 fives are 15 and 4 fives are 20. So children, 4 upon 20 is smaller than 15 upon 20. Okay. Now 1 upon 4 and 1 upon 6. These two are unlike fractions. But also they have same numerators. So children, what do you think? Which one of them should be big? 1 upon 4 should have a greater value or 1 upon 6? 1 upon 4. Why? Because here the denominator is smaller. Okay, but we will do it by this method. These fractions we will do by this method. Okay, so I am going to multiply numerator and denominator here by 6. And here I am going to multiply numerator and denominator by 4. Okay, let us see. 1 6 upon 4 6. 1 4 upon 6 4. Okay. 1 6 6. 4 6 24. 1 4 4. 6 4 24. So 6 upon 24 is big or 4 upon 24 is big? 6 upon 24 is big. Okay, children. Now we will do one more set of comparison of unlike fractions and then I think you will be able to get the concept very thoroughly. Now we have 2 upon 7 and 4 upon 5. Now children, we will multiply the numerator and denominator by which number? Come on, think. Yes, by 5. And here we will multiply the numerator and denominator by which number? Yes, by 7. Okay, 2 fives are 10 and 7 fives are 35. Same way, 7 4s are 28 and 7 5s are 35. See children, 10 upon 35 and 28 upon 35. Here we have got two like fractions. These two are like fractions. Also, this fraction is equal to this fraction and this fraction is equal to this fraction. So, 28 upon 35 is bigger than 10 upon 35. Okay. Now 2 upon 9 and 4 upon 7. Now we will multiply the numerator and denominator by 7. And here we are going to multiply the numerator and denominator by 9. So 4 9s are 36. And 9 sevens are 63. Okay. 2 sevens are 9 sevens are. 4 nines are 7 nines are. So 14 upon 63 and 36 upon 63. Which one is bigger? Obviously 36 upon 63 is bigger. Let us do this last question. 3 upon 8. And 5 upon 6. Now we will multiply 3 by 6 and 8 by 6. And we will multiply 5 by 8 and 6 also by 8. Okay, let us do that. 3 multiplied by 6 and 8 upon 8 multiplied by 6. Here 5 multiplied by 8 and upon 6 multiplied by 8. So 6 threes are 18, 8 6 are 48 8 5 are 40 8 6 are 48. So 18 upon 48 is less than 40 upon 48. So dear children, I hope you would have understood how to compare unlike fractions. That's all for today. Thank you and have a great day.